wake your ass up, cause it's time to go beast mode.
From the BART train to a tour bus, still the same game, except I'm pulling more sluts, more butts, more bucks, never giving more fuck.
In this video, we are reviewing about the manager Fernando Santos. Fernando Santos was born as Fernando Manuel Fernandez da Costa Santos on October 10, 1954 in Lisbon, Portugal. His love for football started since his childhood, and he used to play football with the children in the streets of Lisbon. From his childhood onwards, he loved to play as a defender. Introduced to the football playing with Operário Lisboa, Santos joined in SL Benfica youth system at the age of 16 and played from 1971 to 1973. Later his games earned him the offer to play in the club GD Estoril Praia and made his senior career debut in 1973. Santos earned a degree in electrical and telecommunications engineering in 1977. As he was in charge when Porto won its fifth consecutive championship in 1999, he was nicknamed Penda's Engineer. He was infamous as a defender, but as a manager, he was a great success. He had managed many clubs like FC Porto, Sporting CP and Benfica. He also played the role of a manager for the Greece national team. Fernando Santos signed a two-year deal as the manager for the Greece national team on July 1st, 2010, and even helped the country to qualify for the UEFA Euro 2012, where the team reached last 8th stage. After Paulo Bento was fired, Fernando Santos took over his place to manage Portugal national team on September 23rd, 2014. These were the golden periods of his life. He led Portugal national team to win UEFA Euro 2016, making the team the only undefeated in the tournament. For the 2018 FIFA World Cup qualifiers, he helped the team to finish with 9 wins in 10 games. In the technical command of the Portuguese team, Fernando Santos won the UEFA League of Nations in 2019. He also acquired 3rd position in FIFA Best Men's Coach in 2016. Now let's review about Fernando Santos in PES 20. As we all know that Fernando Santos is a licensed manager in PES 20. He have same formation both in offensive and defensive tactics. He follows 4-3-1-2 formation in PES 20. And his management skill is 850. So you can use players having high player cost. We can use a team which has team strength up to 4600 to 4700. Fernando Santos follows counter-attacking styles in PES 20. At first, let's check up his offensive tactics. The build-up is short pass in offensive tactics, so the scoring is made by short passes. The attacking area is middle, so the role of AMF had a great importance in his formation. So we should assign a better player with good finishing at the position of AMF. As the attacking area is middle, players will not play wide, and so this formation doesn't have wingers. Next, let's review his defensive style in the offensive tactics. Fernando Santos follows front line pressure as his defensive style. In front line pressure, the ball is recovered as soon as you lose the possession on the ball. This strategy is called front line pressure. In offensive tactics, Fernando Santos follows containment area wide. Containment area wide is a defensive technique which makes a trap by giving space to attack through wings. It is really hard to beat the mid area in Santos formation because you can itself see that 3 players are playing in the midfield. Next, if we look towards pressing, it is aggressive. Aggressive pressing means if we had lost the possession on the ball, our players will highly keep pressing on the opponent to regain back the possession. So During aggressive pressing, players will move towards front without maintaining their position. Fernando Santos also follows a good defensive tactics. There are a lot of changes from his offensive tactics. In defensive tactics, the build-up is long pass. If our opponent's defense is stable, we can play short pass in the offensive tactics. If your opponent's defense is not stable, we can play long pass in the defensive tactics. In defensive tactics, if we look towards the containment area, it is middle. Containment area middle is a defensive technique which makes a trap by giving space to attack through middle. If your opponent keeps attacking through wings, you should follow Santos' offensive tactics, and if the opponent keeps attacking through middle, then you should follow Santos' defensive tactics. Next, let's check which players are well suited for Fernando Santos' managing techniques. Let's look which player is well suited on goalkeeping position. We should choose a goalkeeper having playing style as offensive goalkeeper. For example, Manuel Neuer, Mark Ter Stegen, Alisson Becker, De Gea, etc. Next, if we look towards centre backs, we should choose a player with good height, jump, man marking and build up as playing styles as centre back number 1. Examples of players having build up as playing styles are Virgil van Dijk, Harry Maguire, Clement Laglet, Thiago Silva, etc. Then, we should choose a player having playing styles extra frontman as centre back number 2. For example, Gerard Pique, Sergio Ramos, etc. Next, in the case of right backs and left backs, we should choose offensive or defensive fullbacks having good speed. Players well suited for left backs and right backs in Santos formation are Roberto Carlos, Cafu, Andy Robertson, David Alaba, Kyle Walker, etc. Next, in the case of CMFs, the players should be a box-to-box player. As I said before, Santos formation gives more importance to the midfield. So, players having box-to-box playing style can help both in attacking and defending. For example, David Beckham, Alan, Thiago Alcantara, etc. The defensive midfielder should be an anchor man because we can use him as a stay-back defender. Santos follows frontline pressure. So there may be a chance for the players to shuffle from their positions. So it is better to use a stable anchor man than a destroyer. For example, Sergio Busquets, Casemiro, Fabinho, etc. If we choose a player to aim of position, a player having creative playmaker or hold player is well suited for this position. AMF plays a great role in the attacking in Santos formation. For example, Kevin De Bruyne, Neymar, etc. As we move towards centre forward position, a goal poacher and a fox in the box is well suited to this position. The player should have good accuracy in first time shots because in Santos formation, the attack area is middle, so that possession game is not possible in Santos formation. The combination of these two playing styles really sharpens the attack. Examples of goal poachers are Kylian Mbappe, Sergio Aguero, Roberto Lewandowski, etc. And examples of fox in the box are Lukaku, Zapata, etc. In substitution bench, always use players that can replace players in the attacking position. You should always keep a player of this position in sub. They are 1 AMF, 2 CMF and a CF. And it is better to have a super sub and one each player of centre midfield and centre back. As in real football, Fernando Santos is one of the best manager in PES 20. If you use these tips, you can sharpen your attack in this formation. And let's wind up this video. Thanks for watching. It's me, Justin, signing off from Dead LC. Thank you.